What's up, YouTube world? It's your boy, the one, aka the one and only, you already know. Hey, I know it's been a minute since I've been on this thing and did a video for y'all, man. My bad, and I promise y'all, y'all stay down with me. I promise you, it's gonna get better and better. I'm gonna have more and more content for y'all, man, from y'all favorite artists. But anyway, man, I'm bringing y'all this story from Akon, speak song. tekashi69. Akon takes up for tekashi69, saying 69 didn't know what he was getting himself into and wonder why shoddy put him in the position to snitch, knowing that he was the moneymaker of the team and that shoddy should have protected him instead of the other way around, knowing that he wasn't built for the position that he led him in. With all the information that was given, y'all check out the video and I'll be back later with my thoughts.
Because you know Tekashi's out, so maybe you might be.
Nah, Tekashi, that's my little man, y'all. You know what? All right. It's funny because this the thing, right? He's young, bro. His generation and our generation ain't the same. Yeah. We gotta teach them different. You know what I'm saying? Because you gotta understand when kids get in a situation like that, and I look at him still as a young, young G that was surrounded by a whole bunch of people that didn't inform him or that didn't educate him properly as to what he was getting himself into. You gotta understand when, as just human nature, when people get caught up in situations, they're gonna follow their survival instinct immediately. And you gotta know that. If I'm an OG, I'm not gonna put somebody that young, that inexperienced, or that uneducated to the streets like that in a situation where I know that if we get caught up, there may be a possibility that he might fold on it. You follow what I'm saying? He has, young. He hasn't been in the game that long to see the value of what that is. And then when you stop and you have to, literally decide what's more valuable to you, my family, my future, as a child now, versus me doing this and don't know what my future leads to. You got to make a decision that's going to better you at what you understand life to be at that moment in time. Now, me and you, there ain't no excuses because we've been through the trenches. We understand what that is. We can't do that and get away with it. We just can't because we know better. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? People like Tekashi, we just got to teach them because he's not the only one out there like that. That whole generation is like that. So we got to teach them better. We got to give them a better understanding of what they're walking into, what the implications are, and more than anything, what that fucking punishment becomes. So until you ready for that, don't get caught up in that. Don't surround yourself around people that's going to put you in that situation. There's no reason why he should even been in the position where he sits. His homies should have took that for him. Yeah. Them niggas that claim to be real G's and all that, they should have took that for him. Because he's the football. You always protect the football. You don't never put the artist in a situation where he has to cover for y'all. Get around to make sure he's covered and protected. So that way everybody's future is covered. So but if you got people around you that's supposed to protect you and protect the future of what this group could, you know, represent, and then those niggas looking like there's no future or no security towards you, bro, you're going to protect yourself at that point. And that's just the bottom line. There's nobody that surrounds me that if I went through something like that, they wouldn't take the hit for me. I know for a fact I wouldn't have to worry about that because one of my homies is going to take that. And I'm going to make sure he's straight, his family's straight, and everybody that's surrounded or connected to that somehow is good. And that's what it is.
You made millions from this kid. You know what I'm saying?
More do you want from this nigga? You want his life too? Come on, bro. This nigga's young. Come on, man. I just didn't agree with that. And I know there's codes that we live by, whatever the case. Yeah. But these codes have rules attached to them. And then there's morals attached to those rules. And if any one of them are broken, man, it's fair game, bro. Because I know me as well. I know today I'm not doing nothing. If I plan to go there or do anything, I'm doing it by myself. I'm not involving nobody. I'm going to go ahead quietly, do what I got to do, and go back, jump on that stage, and nothing happened, bro. On everything. I'm not about to involve nobody and then expect that person to cherish or humble himself for my life as if he would do it for his own. Everybody, it's always going to be to each his own. It's just a matter of pressure that you apply on somebody that determines how long they keep that vow towards you. And everybody gonna crack, and everybody has the possibility to crack. Trust me, you can ask those Vietnamese soldiers who was built for that. They still crack. So you expect somebody that never been through that to not crack? Come on, bro. It don't even make sense.
Well, look, man, you gave me another perspective of it. I think I got lost in hearing you know, street coded dudes talking about it, then they don't look at.
But it'd be the same niggas talking street code that don't follow it themselves.
Right? Yeah. Yeah. Well, I don't want to give you a list of rappers out there that we know that they get caught in certain situations. And that's just
you see them all the time.
Yo, but it's just that crazy.
You interviewed a lot of them.
But it shows you how quick social media is. Like they put their snitch shit out there, and then it just goes away. And then the rapper's back in the light, like, hey, nothing happened. I'm the man again. You know what I'm saying?
Because there's two parts, right? You got life, and then you got your career. Don't ever mix your life with your career. The only part of life that you allow to be a part of your career is what you stand for as a person, as a man, and as a brand, because that also attaches to you as a person. But don't ever mix the two. You have to have your life completely separate from your career, period. So guess what? When your life is in the shambles, focus on that career. When your career is in the shambles, that means your life needs to be fixed. Either way, they go hand in hand, but they move parallel, but you cannot put them together. This is why a lot of rappers don't live to see the success, because they involve their personal life too much into the business.
Yeah. Well, you need to write a book on that shit, man, so these idiots can read that shit, man, and learn.
It's common sense. It's common sense. That's like involving family in business without teaching them first. Just because they're family don't mean they should be a part of your business. But if they understand